So welcome to the next lecture that will be on same, that is on the transmission characteristics second. So these are the learning outcomes. At end of this session, students will be able to express different types of scattering attenuations in optical signal. So in the previous lecture, we have seen the types of attenuations in the optical cable when the data is being transferred from the transmitter to the receiver. So we have seen the material absorptions are due to the eccentric and eccentric conditions. So we have seen that is the scattering problem is there. One more problem is there on the dispersion, and one more problem is there on the micro bending and the micro bending losses here. So before starting to this basic of scattering losses, just a recall that what are the types of the attenuations we have studied in the previous video lecture, and what we have seen is that the attenuation goes on decreasing when there is an increase in the wavelength here. So is it right or wrong? So we'll start with the basic of scattering losses. This is due to the norm uniformity in the fiber optics while manufacturing. That is, the straight line path of light rays get deviated. It is referred as a scattering. So this is an optical cable, fiber optical cable, which consists of the core and cladding. Inside this, the light is being transmitted from the transmitter side here. So the light should be follow the total internal reflection so that the data should be transmitted from the transmitter to the receiver side here. But this is due to the scattering is due to the non-uniformity of the fiber optics while manufacturing. So that is mainly caused due to the interaction of light with the density fluctuations in within the fiber. So while manufacturing that the density is not same throughout the core here. So the material which has been used to make this core and cladding here. So what will happen when the light is going to be transmitted here, when it gets deflected due to that, so the light will get transmitted from the core to the cladding and that data will be dispersed. So such type of losses are known as the scattering losses here. So we'll see the basic scattering mechanisms. That is, the scattering is being divided into two types. That is the linear scattering as well as the non-linear scattering here. So there is a difference between the linear scattering and the non-linear scattering here. So when the optical power is being transmitted from one mode to the another mode here, but there is no change in the frequency on the scattering here. So such type of things are known as the linear scattering here. And there are two types of that is linear scattering are there. That is Rayleigh scattering and the Mie scattering here. In the same manner, if you see the non-linear scattering, that whenever the optical power is being transmitted from one mode to the another mode or the some other or the same mode with a different frequency, there is a change in the frequency when the scattering will takes place here. So there are two types of linear scattering, that is the stimulated Berylian scattering, that is SBS, and the Raman scattering, that is also known as the stimulated Raman scattering here. So now in this video lecture, we'll be discussing the details about the Rayleigh's, Mie, and the non-linear scattering, that is SBS and the SRS here. So this is the Rayleigh scattering here. So when does the Rayleigh scattering occurs? The size of the density fluctuation is less than 1/10 of the operating wavelength of the light here. So when it is being transmitted, when the size of the density fluctuation is less than 1/10 of the operating wavelength of the light, so at that time the Rayleigh scattering will occurs. So this is the same figure when the light is being transmitted, whose the density fluctuation is less than 1/10 of the operating wavelength, so the light get scattered in this manner. So the Rayleigh scattering components can be reduced by the operating at the longest possible wavelength. So we have seen that as we go on increasing your the wavelength, the attenuation goes on decreasing. So the Rayleigh will also be the same here, operating at the longest possible wavelength, your Rayleigh scattering will be less. So how we are going to calculate the attenuation loss due to the Rayleigh scattering? It is denoted by YR, that is an eta, is equal to 8 pi q n 8 p into beta c k f t f. Upon 3 lambda 4 here. So where most important thing is your lambda, that is then optical wavelength. N is nothing but your the refractive index of the medium, and P is the average photoelastic coefficient, and beta C is the isothermal compressibility at the temperature TF, and the K is nothing but your Boltzmann constant here. So if you want to calculate, that is how much loss is there due to the Rayleigh scattering, so we have to make use of this formula here. So we'll see afterwards that how the Rayleigh scattering will be affected various wavelength here. So we'll take one 800 micrometer, that is nanometer, and then 1000 nanometers, and then we'll see the highest wavelength, that is then 1500 nanometer here. So from this we'll understand that how we are going to increase the size of an wavelength at that time the attenuation is going to be less here. So we'll solve one example on that. So now it is the my scattering here. It is the same like when the size of the defect is greater than the 1/10 of the wavelength of light, then the scattering mechanism is called as an my scattering here. So when the size of and density fluctuation is less than 1/10, it is a Rayleigh. But when the size of the defect is greater than 1/10 of the wavelength of light, then the scattering mechanism is called as an my scattering. So the my scattering is caused due to the large defect in the fiber core and the scatter lights out of the fiber core here. So as we have seen in the Rayleigh scattering, so when the light is going to be scattered, it is going to be into the cladding region here. But the my scattering can be reduced by the removing imperfection during the glass manufacturing process. So these losses are due to the manufacturing losses like Rayleigh and the my. So it can be removed while removing the imperfections during the manufacturing process. Then controlling the coating of fiber means what we are going to make use of in the core and cladding, and the mechanical coating on which we is going to make use of the optical fiber, and increasing the refractive index of the difference between the core and cladding. So if you take care of all these three points, so the my scattering will be less in that. Okay. So now we'll see the non-linear scattering, that is known as the stimulated beryllium scattering, that is known as the SBS here. So when the light is passed through an optical fiber, there are the variations in the electrical field of the beam here. These variations in the electrical field produce the acoustic vibrations in the optical cable as well as the scatter photon here. So when the light is passed through then the optical cable, there is an variations in the electrical field because the light is being transmitted in the form of electromagnetic waves as an light. So it consists of electrical and the magnetic field. So there is a variations in the electrical field which produces the acoustic vibrations and the scatter photon here. That scattered light aspects like an upper and the lower sidebands, which are the detached from the incident light by the modulation frequency. So there is a change in the frequency because it scattered in the forward as well as in the backward direction here. Now if you want to calculate that how much threshold optical power is there for the beryllium, so it is given by PB 4.4 into 10 raised to minus 3 d square lambda square, that is alpha it in dB, and then V watts. So it is calculated in watt. So where you know that d and lambda are the fiber core diameter and the operating wavelength respectively. Alpha dB is nothing but the fiber attenuations in the decimal per kilometer, and V is the source bandwidth in the gigahertz. So it is important while measuring in the laser generation. So when you are going to make use of a laser as then source to transmit the data here. So at that time the stimulated beryllium scattering, we have to see that there is no any scatter photon or the acoustic vibration here. In the similar manner, if you are going to see the stimulated Raman scattering here, it is also the same like the SBS, but it is an high frequency optical photon is generated like the SBS, that the process is begun by the noise and the thermally made fluctuations in the optical field and active vibrational mode. So due to which the light is going to be scattered here. So if you want to calculate the threshold optical power also for the Raman, it is given by PR, that is 5.6 into 10 raised to minus 2 D2 lambda alpha dB in watts. So where you know that D and the lambda are at the fiber core diameter and the operating wavelength, and alpha dB is nothing but the fiber attenuations in the decimal per kilometer here. as the stimulated Raman is very high in the watt here. Now suppose we will see the examples on this also. So PB, if it comes to be 1 milliwatt, then it stimulated Raman scattering will appear at least 10 milliwatt here. So the more threshold power is there for the Raman. So this was all about the scattering. So in which we have seen the linear and non-linear. So in the linear, we have seen that is Rayleigh's and Mach, and Rayleigh's will occur when it is the less than 1/10 of your operating wavelength, that is the density fluctuation. And Mach's we have seen that is if it is greater than 1/10 of the operating wavelength. And the Raman and the beryllium will occur due to the acoustic photons, vibrations and the photons being generated here. So this was the related to your scattering. So we'll see now the examples how to calculate the Rayleigh scattering now here. So these are my references. Thank you.